Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture on applied hydraulics. In this video lecture we'll be discussing on impact of jet on curved vane. We'll be discussing on problems on velocity triangle concept. Now coming to a problem, a jet of water of diameter 50 mm having a velocity of 20 meters per second strikes a curved vane which is moving with a velocity of 10 meters per second in the direction of jet. The jet leaves the vane at an angle of 60 degrees to the direction of motion of the vane at outlet. Determine the force exerted by the jet on the vane in the direction of motion and work done per second by the jet. So here if you go through the problem statement, here the diameter of the jet is mentioned, which is 50 mm, and the velocity of the jet is mentioned, which is 20 meters per second. The velocity with which the vane is moving, it is 10 meters per second, and the angle made by the absolute velocity at the outlet is given, which is beta star, and it is 60 degrees. Now as I have mentioned, diameter is mentioned, velocity of the jet at inlet is mentioned, which is 20 meters per second, velocity of vane is 10 meters per second, angle made by the jet with the direction of motion of the vane at inlet, alpha is 0, and angle made by the jet with the direction of motion of the vane at outlet, beta star, is 60 degrees. Therefore beta we can find as 180 minus 60 degrees, which is 120 degrees. So here the vane velocity at inlet and outlet is same, which is 10 meters per second. Now this is the velocity triangle diagram. So since the direction of motion of the vane and direction of motion of the jet is in the same direction, the inlet velocity triangle will be a straight line. So here the velocity with which the jet strikes the vane will be the relative velocity, which is the algebraic difference between the velocity of the jet and velocity of the vane. So VR1 will be equal to V1 minus U1, which is, since U1 is equals to U, so we can rewrite this equation as V1 minus U. Therefore the relative velocity at inlet will be 10 meters per second, and the velocity of whirl V1 will be 20 meters per second. And since beta is greater than 90 degrees, velocity of whirl at the outlet will be equal to U2 minus VR2 cos pi. In the previous case it was VR2 cos pi minus U2. So since here beta is greater than 90 degrees, the velocity of whirl at the outlet is U2 minus VR2 cos pi. And also they have not mentioned that whether the vane surface is rough or smooth. So we need to assume the vane surface to be smooth. So if vane surface is smooth, the relative velocity at the outlet will be equal to the relative velocity at inlet. So VR2 will be equal to VR1, which is 10 meters per second. Now from the outlet velocity triangle diagram, that is triangle GEF, here EG is 10 meters per second and GF is 10 meters per second. Therefore angle GEF will be, now angle EGF is pi and angle GFE is 180 minus beta. Beta is 120 degrees. So this angle, that is GFE, will be 60. So angle GEF will be 180 minus 60 plus pi, and if we simplify it is 120 minus pi. Now from sine rule we have AG divided by sine 60 is equal to GF divided by sine of 120 minus pi. So if we simplify, we will be getting pi as 60 degrees. So if we substitute the value of pi and U2 and VR2 in equation 1, if we simplify, we will be getting the value of VW2. So VW2 will be equal to GF minus GH, and GH is VR2 cos pi. So 10 cos 60 has been substituted. So VW2, which is HF, it will be 5 meters per second. Now The force exerted by the jet on the vane in the direction of motion is given by the expression F is equals to rho A VR1 into the bracket VW1 minus VW2. So if we substituted all the values, we'll be getting the value of force as 294.52 Newton. And the expression for work done per second by the jet is given by the product of the force exerted and the vane velocity, that is F into U. So if you substitute and find the value, we'll be getting 2945.2 watts. Now coming to another problem, here a jet of water having a velocity of 15 meters per second strikes a curved vane which is moving with a velocity of 5 meters per second in the same direction as that of jet at inlet. The vane is so shaped that the jet is deflected through 135 degrees. The diameter of the jet is given, which is 100 millimeters. Assuming the vane to be smooth, we need to find the force exerted by the jet on the vane in the direction of motion of the vane, power exerted on the vane, and efficiency of the vane. So if you go through the problem statement, the velocity of jet is given, which is 15 meters per second, and vane velocity is given, which is 5 meters per second. And it has been mentioned that the direction of motion of the jet and direction of motion of the vane is same. So the inlet velocity triangle diagram will be a straight line. And it has also been mentioned that the vane is so shaped that the jet is deflected by 135 degrees. So if the jet is deflected by 135 degrees, so pi will be 180 minus 135, which is 45 degrees, which has been mentioned here. Now, so this is the velocity triangle diagram. As I have mentioned, the inlet velocity triangle diagram is a straight line, and this is the velocity triangle diagram for outlet. Now, since alpha is equal to 0, the inlet velocity triangle diagram is a straight line. So VR1 is the algebraic difference between the velocity of the vane, VR1 is the algebraic difference between the velocity of jet and velocity of the vane, which is 10 meters per second. And also the vane is smooth, so VR2 will be equal to VR1. And since here alpha is equal to 0, so VW1 will be equal to V1, which is 15 meters per second. So from outlet velocity triangle diagram, that is DEG, VR2 cos pi is equal to U2 plus VW2. Therefore, VW2 will be equal to VR2 cos pi minus U2. So if we substitute the value of pi, U2 and VR2, we'll be getting the value of VW2, which is 2.07 meters per second. Now, the force exerted by the jet on the vane is given by the formula F is equal to rho A VR1 into the bracket VW1 plus VW2. So if we substitute all those values, that is rho as 1000, A which is pi by 4 d square is 0.1, and VR1 which is 10, VW1 which is 15, and VW2 which is 2.07. So if we substitute all these values, we'll be getting the value of, or I can say the magnitude of force exerted as 1340.674 Newton. Now, power exerted by the jet. Power exerted by the jet is nothing but the work done by the jet on the vane, which is given by the formula, the product of force into vane velocity. And if we substitute the value, we will be getting the value as 6.703 kilowatts. Now, the expression for efficiency of the vane is given by the ratio of work done per second by the jet divided by the kinetic energy of the jet per second. Now, work done per second we have already found, and the kinetic energy of the jet per second is given by the formula half rho A V into V1 square. So if we substitute all those value, it will be 50.57%. Coming to another problem, a jet of water having a velocity of 45 meters per second impinges without shock on a series of vane moving at 15 meters per second. The direction of motion of the vane is included at 20 degrees to that of jet. The relative velocity at the outlet is 0.9 times as that of inlet. And outlet velocity of water at exit is to be normal to the motion of the vane. Find the vane angles at the inlet and outlet, work done on the vanes per newton of water supplied by the jet, and hydraulic efficiency. Now, if you just go through the problem, here the jet velocity is given, which is 45 meters per second. The velocity of the vane is given, which is 15 meters per second. And the angle made by the jet with respect to the direction of motion is given, which is 20 degrees. And also, it has been mentioned like the relative velocity at the outlet is 0.9 times the relative velocity at inlet. Now, at exit, the velocity of water will be normal to the motion of the vane. So, we can say beta is 90 degrees, which has been shown here. So, angle made by the jet with respect to the direction of motion of the vane, alpha is 20 degrees. Now, from the inlet velocity triangle diagram, that is this diagram, tan theta is BD divided by CD. So BD is the velocity of the flow at inlet, and CD is AD minus AC. AD is velocity of whirl at inlet, and AC is the vane velocity at inlet. So if we substitute the values, so tan theta will be equal to 0.564, therefore theta will be equal to 29.42 degrees. Also, again from triangle BCD, sin theta is VF1 divided by VR1. So VR1 will be equal to VF1 divided by sin theta. So if we simplify, the relative velocity at the inlet will be 31.33 meters per second. Since in the problem it has been mentioned like the relative velocity at outlet is 0.9 times the relative velocity at inlet, so VR2 will be equal to 0.9 times of 31.33, which is 28.19 meters per second. Now, from the outlet velocity triangle diagram, here beta is 90 degrees, so V2 will be equal to VF2 and VW2 will be 0. So cos pi is equal to U2 divided by VR2, which is U divided by VR2. So pi is cos inverse of 15 divided by 28.19, and the value of this pi is 57.85 degrees. So we can find the value of work done on the vanes per newton of water supplied by the jet, which is given by the formula W is equal to 1 by G into VW1 into U1. So if we substitute this value, VW1 will be equal to 64.65 newton, and hydraulic efficiency per newton of water is given by work done divided by kinetic energy of the jet per newton. So work done, which is 64.65, and kinetic energy of the jet per newton is given by V1 square by 2G. So if we substitute this value and if we simplify, we'll be getting 62.65 percentage. Coming to another problem, a jet of water having a velocity of 35 meters per second impinges on a series of vane moving with a velocity of 20 meters per second. The jet makes an angle of 30 degrees in the direction of motion of the vane when entering and leaves at an angle of 120 degrees. Draw the triangle of velocities at inlet and outlet and find the angle of vane tips so that water enters and leaves the vane without shock, and work done per newton of water entering the vanes and the efficiency. So here, if you go through the statement of the problem, the velocity of jet is given, which is 35 meters per second, and velocity of vane is given, which is 20 meters per second, and the angle between the velocity of jet and velocity of the vane is 30 degrees, that is alpha is 30 degrees, and angle made by the jet at outlet is 120 degrees. This is beta star. So beta will be 180 minus 120, which is 60 degrees. So this is the velocity triangle diagram. This is the velocity triangle diagram that is at inlet and outlet to the vane. So from triangle ABD, Vf1 is equal to V1 sin pi, whose value is 17.5 meter per second, and velocity of whirl at inlet, which is V1 cos alpha. So if we substitute, we'll be getting the value of 30.31 meters per second. So tan theta is given by Vf1, which is BD divided by CD. So CD we have found, which is AD minus AC. So tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1 minus U1, and this value of theta is 59.49 degrees. Again, from this inlet velocity triangle diagram itself, Vr1 divided by sin 90 is equal to Bf1 divided by sin 90. Therefore, we can find the value of the relative velocity at inlet. So Vr1 will be 20.31 meters per second. And since they have mentioned that the relative velocity at inlet is equal to the relative velocity at the outlet, so Vr2 will be equal to Vr1, which is 20.31 meters per second. Now, if we apply sine rule to the outlet triangle, we have Vr2 divided by sine of 180 minus beta is equal to U2 divided by sine of beta minus pi. That is, consider this triangle, Vr2 divided by sine of 180 minus beta, that is angle FGE, and U2 divided by sine of FEG, that is beta minus pi. This angle is beta minus pi. So sine of beta minus pi is 0.852. if we simplify, that is using this relationship, so beta minus pi is 58.51 degrees, so pi is 1.482 degrees. Now, work done per newton of water entering the vane is given by the expression W is equal to 1 by G Vw1 plus Vw2 into U. So here we have taken positive, that is plus, because beta is acute. So if we substitute the value of Vw1, Vw2 and U, we'll be getting the value of work done per newton of water, which is 62.40 newton meter per newton. And hydraulic efficiency is given by work done per newton divided by energy supplied by the jet per newton. So work done per newton is 62.40 and energy supplied per newton, which is V1 square by 2G. If we substitute this value, we'll be getting the efficiency as 0.9994, which is 99.94%. These are my references. Thank you.